This is Charlie Jordan, and this is the third Colebrook Chronicle News Extra update on the blasts which struck the MDM plant in Colebrook yesterday, claiming two lives. This report is being filed on Saturday evening, May 15th at 10 p.m., and the investigation into the cause of the blast at the muzzleloader plant continues. Authorities have not yet released the names of the two fatalities, but tonight WMUR is reporting that Jesse Kennett, 49, of Stratford, is one of those who were killed. His obituary states that he is survived by his wife and daughter. A memorial service and funeral will be held next Friday, May 21st, at 5 p.m. at the Armstrong Chair and Funeral Home in Groveton. The residents on Bridge Street have been allowed to return to their homes, but a number of people who live in a very close proximity to the plant have not, including those who live in an apartment building on Gould Street leading into the complex. This afternoon, authorities sought and received a search warrant to enter the building, seeking further evidence that may help reveal what caused the massive series of blasts, which could be heard and seen as far as 10 miles away. The Colebrook Chronicle spoke with David Bray, the facilities manager for the entire structure, which housed the muzzleloader company as well as the River of Life Church.
Has anybody given you an update on the extent of the damage in the building?
From what I've heard, it's kind of broken up into three sections, and the section towards the east is pretty much destroyed. It looks like the sections, the other middle section and the section on the west side is still intact.
Do you think the building is salvageable, or do you think it will?
Until I get in there, I don't have a clue. I'm just taking pictures, kind of looking from what I can see from here. My sense is that the section where the MDM was and where the River of Life Church was, that's probably gone. Yeah. Just talked with the guy from MDM, and he's so shook up that we just decided to postpone and wait for another time. I know that the church, I didn't talk with him, but the owner spoke with him yesterday afternoon. He had just left the building about 20 minutes beforehand, was leaving for vacation, and got the word, so he came back into town.
Definitely.
The tragedy is the loss of life. I mean, you can always rebuild a building, but when somebody gets hurt, that's the...
Earlier today, the door to the Monadnock Congregational Church in Colebrook was open for prayer and meditation. We spoke with Reverend Rebecca Larson.
We've opened our doors from 10 o'clock until noontime to allow people to just come in, and as they're moved, to come in and pray for the people and for this whole community. This is a devastating thing for the whole community. And I just want to provide a place for people to come and find comfort and solace. We've opened our doors to the River of Life congregation, who has been displaced too, and they will be worshiping here tomorrow afternoon at 1:30. Ruth Lewis is playing the organ, and we've filled the altar with candles, and I have lit the two center candles in memory of the two people who lost their lives. And there's, people can go up to the altar and light a candle.
Photographs and videos taken moments after the blasts, including these photos taken just across the Connecticut River from Leamington, Vermont, continue to come into news organizations. This video of the black cloud which filled the skies over Colebrook moments after the first blasts was shot by Brendan McDonald from Cooper Hill. If you have photographs and videos that you'd like to share with the Colebrook Chronicle, which will be providing more coverage on this story next Friday, please send them to editor@colebrookchronicle.com. For more information on this story, visit www.colebrookchronicle.com.